Hi, this is Bill Petrus. I'm the art director on World of Warcraft, and I'm happy to introduce the lead art staff of World of Warcraft.
I'm Kyle Harrison, the lead technical artist.
I'm Brandon Idle, lead character artist.
Justin Tabrat, lead artist.
I'm Kevin Beardsley, the lead animator.
One of the biggest things that we did early on is we really had to look at the Warcraft look, and we really had to figure out, hey guys, what are we actually going to be doing in this project? We did a lot of experiments with different scales of exaggeration. We also had a different style for the textures, and we realized that it wasn't the Warcraft look. It was not there, and we had to modify that look, and what you see today is basically the blood, sweat, and tears of many years of work to try and get that style. And in some ways, we actually pushed the style. We really wanted to make our game feel like multiple artists just really lovingly rendered this game out, everywhere from the animations to the modeling to the texturing to the lighting, the exaggerated scales of things. The animations filled with character.
You can just tell by, strongly exaggerated poses and animations that, we drew from Frazetta and Disney, references that we drew from, really strong references.
With the environmental work, some of the major influences obviously were like N.C. Wyeth, Howard Pyle, Dean Cornwell, some of the older American landscape artists. We really wanted to capture that atmosphere, that feel in our game, where you go from one area to the other and you can feel the heat of the zone. It's interesting when you're working on a project like this, as complicated and as big it is, because you don't really see all the pieces come together at the same time. This particular artist does his job over here, and it takes a while for it to get into the game and to be played. And at some point in development, I don't really remember when, just when all of it started to come together, and we were just really excited to be like, wow, this really is coming together. I don't remember exactly when that was. When was that?
I think it was when Westfall kind of got put together.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yeah. The lighting came together, the textures came together, the player character, one of our first creatures, the Gnoll, basically just nailed that Warcraft look and feel, both with texture, model, and animation. I mean, I think that's when it came together.
Westfall was definitely the start of really capturing the look of what the game was going to be.
One thing that I think really sets WoW apart from other games out there is that we really refuse to go down the assembly line process. Every time we approached a new zone or a new area that the player would explore, we wanted them to be completely rewarded in every way whatsoever. So from the lighting to the sky, all the way down to just the little brush and brambles on the ground or the ambient creatures that would be running around that area, we made sure that it was fresh every time. And we came through a meticulously created new art, new even techniques each time we got to a new area.
I think the team was never really happy with just what we were working with. We always were pushing the envelope. We always wanted to just maximize the technology that we had. We made sure that our textures worked twice as hard.
It was really refreshing to have different perspectives from all over the art department, whether a texture artist came in and commented on the animation or a designer walked in and said, oh, I think this would look cooler if it was bigger. It was really an open back and forth communication, which I think, in the long run, it's a very iterative process. It might take a little longer than, say, a different method of doing it. But I think in the end, it works out for the best, and everyone kind of gets their 2 cents in on some stage of the game there.
I was always impressed at just how open each team was in respecting another group or another little development group or an area of development that would come in and say, hey, we noticed that, this maybe was not reaching its full potential, or we felt like maybe we could try this and it would be a little cooler. And people were always very open to at least hear that and sort of get that line of communication going back and forth. So that really helped to build us, I think, more in a very strong direction.
We continually are replacing and upgrading and doing things to the world that we want to change. And so we're going to continue to do that for the next, I don't know how many years.
A lot of times our philosophy seems to start at sort of minimalist. We say, well, we want to keep the art reined in. We don't want to like really eat up any unneeded CPU time trying to render this. So what we do is we kind of create the art at the lowest level we can and try to make it look good at that level. And then we find as a year or two goes by and hardware gets faster on computers, we can then come through and sort of finesse a little bit, add a few of the things that we maybe skimped over to begin with, and we just make it that much better by kind of refining it.
The iterative process, just going back and making everything polished, and you'll just notice that even before it gets into the game, sometimes there's a dozen drawings for one creature before it gets put in the game, and hopefully we'll be able to show you some of just the rejected ideas and just how much goes into the final one that makes it into the game.
early on, the concepts that we were having, we were showing the artists that were modeling and texturing. We're like, the Warcraft style is super thick and exaggerated, just huge bulging biceps, everything pushed at the maximum. And that's just kind of the way that we approached it. And originally we had some artists that were like, you want me to make that hand 5 times bigger? Are you sure? We're like, yes. And they were like, I don't know. And we're like, just do it. And then once they started doing, they were realizing like, wow, this is the style. This is what we're looking for.
The animation is very exaggerated in this game, but at the same time, it still has weight and still has a level of realism to it. So, you know, it's still believable.
I think one of the pivotal areas of our art is that it's not so much about detail. It's about form, it's about light, and it's about color. The artists pay more attention to the shape or form of an object or the texture of the surface and how the light plays off of that, and how they can get that across mood-wise with colors.
I totally agree. I think it's like, it's the illusion of something rather than creating all the little details. If you can create that illusion where people go, oh, wow, that's it, and it's less polys and less texture space, then we've done our job.
Yeah, so in addition, what is the Warcraft style? And we've had to break open all the old books and manuals and look at it, and I can think of some of the Sammy, the art director, you know, his old sketches, or Chris Metzen's, you know, and some of the definitive little pieces, like just the big boots. Like, everyone's got these size, like, 16 shoes in the Warcraft world. The boots are bigger than their thighs and things like that, and just trying to carry it down into the role-playing game perspective, but still trying to maintain that overall look and feel, you know, like everything meshes together, everything flows.
Yeah, even down to the user interface and the icons. I mean, everything just mm-hmm. melds together.
The icons in particular, we...
thousands of them. I think there are thousands of icons.
Thousands of icons, and not only that, but each one is just so handcrafted. It's just so lovingly painted. It was so amusing just to sit and watch how meticulously they would paint these things and concentrate on the colors and the form. And they're just fun to look at. And we actually, that was really part of the design from the art standpoint, was that you're looking at icons a lot in this kind of game, and that really is more than anything what's representing it, unless you're directly using that item in the world. So we knew that they had to be big and colorful, and you really had to just get rewarded just by looking at it.
In the midst of schedules and everything, it's important not to get too bogged down and have fun. Kind of, I think one of the things that defines a Warcraft is it kind of has a sense of humor. It doesn't take itself too seriously. At some points, that's kind of a challenge to infuse into this role-playing game. But we did our best. And I think if you can work in development and just kind of enjoy it and kind of laugh at it, and again, not take it too seriously, just have fun.
I think one of the things that always would bring a smile to your face, even in the darkest days, is the old Shane Cube. Whenever there's a model missing a texture or some error,
we have a producer, Shane, who accidentally got his face stuck on a piece of art that represents anything that doesn't display properly in the game. So he's all over the place, actually.
His face shows up in newspapers, articles, and cartoons and everything.